darling?
Yeah.
Ah.
How do you like my haircut?
Oh, that's very macho.
Well, someone here's got to look macho. All of you lot are going to be pranced around like Nancy boys in your skirt. Hi, Auntie Min.
I give you a fair warning, my lad. If you say anything that puts Fergus into a lather tomorrow, you'll have to deal with me.
Yeah, sure. No worries, Auntie Min.
The word skirt will not pass your lips.
No way.
Good.
Ah, yes, nearly all, Mr. Haggis. Oh, no. But anyhow, we're all met now. And the Haggis is ready. Now, Andrew, Stuart, a dram for everyone. And Ronald?
Yeah.
You may take the haggis.
Thank you.
Your honest, sonsy face, great chieftain of the Putin race, Bunama, you tack your place, pinch tripe or fair, weel are you worthy or grace, slangs my arum.
To the haggis.
So early.
Nail polish. Mum, I know the really paper one is here somewhere. I said I was going to wear that corally one that Lynn recommended, but I don't want to now. I want to wear the one that Stephanie
likes. All right, it'll be here. What's it called?
I don't know. I can't remember, Mum. It's really pale. Oh, there's some more in the bathroom.
Libby. Don't worry about it. This is just nerves.
Is it?
Yes.
Mum, I've never felt like this before.
Oh, sweet.
What time does Steph say she'll be here?
No, she should be back by now. She's probably in the shower, love. Now stop worrying about her, will you? I'll ring as soon as your dad gets off the phone.
Hey, the church looks brilliant.
You're gonna love it.
I think we need a cup of tea.
Susan, can I put the kettle on?
Yeah.
Oh, I think something stronger's called for.
Oh, good. Oh, the champagne then.
Oh,
now, what about the flowers?
Oh, they're beautiful.
Everyone did a sterling job.
Darling, you are gonna love it. Oh.
Bye. Great. Just thrown a spanner in the works.
What?
Grandpa Tom. Predictably, now it's the horse.
What?
Castro has gone lame and Dad's in a dither over.
Oh.
Can't your father come?
Oh. Rose, he's one of the last of the red raggers. He's been kicking up the whole time about going into a church. This is his latest excuse.
No, Carl, he said he would go into the church.
No, I know, Grandpa Tom. If it's a choice between Castro and me, then the horse wins.
No. Oh, darling, not true. You're his favourite.
Yes, and he adores Drew.
Drew hasn't got a political bone in his body.
Dad'd see that as a challenge.
Well, maybe if I give him a ring. Oh, there's someone at the door.
I'll get it, thank you.
They'll have set you back.
Oh, Steph, thank God.
Okay, now look, I ran into the florist out the front. He dumped these in my arms. He's gone to Drew's. He got your bouquets and your crossbows, right?
Yes. Let's get some photos.
Oh, sorry,
these are
right. Every stage she's has to be photographed. You'll be happy later.
Now,
smile.
Dude, put that blasted thing away.
Yeah, listen, mate, go and brush your hair. Your mother will have a fit if you turn up to church looking like that. Ah, it's my wild Highland lad. He's all right.
Look, my knees are shaking already. Do you think they're going to see that under the kilt? You'll be fine, mate.
Yeah, listen, your flashes are too far around. Line them up with your arms. Yeah, and the skin do. Over on the other leg, Andrew.
Oh.
Yeah.
Dougal!
Okay, come on, all of you. Scully family photo. Over here, under the tree.
Look at the church in shot.
Right.
Dad. Joe!
Okay. Smile! They're here.
Yes, how are you, man?
Yes,
all right.
Oh,
the young one.
Sorry. Happy step and you, Reverend. Ready? Smile. Okay, one for me. Oh, Here, let me take the free
dog. Oh, good girl. Yeah, great. You all set? Come on.
Beloved, we are gathered together in the sight of God and in the face of this congregation to unite this man, Andrew, and this woman, Elizabeth, in holy matrimony. Elizabeth, will you have Andrew to be your husband, to live together according to God's word? Will you give him the honor due to him as your husband, and forsaking all others, love and protect him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
I, Andrew, in the presence of God.
I, Andrew, in the presence of God.
Take you, Elizabeth, to be my wife.
Take you, Elizabeth, to be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love, honor, and cherish as long as we both shall live.
To love, honor, and cherish as long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow and promise.
This is my solemn vow and promise.
Elizabeth, with this ring I wed you.
With all that I am and all that I have, I honor you.
With all that I am and all that I have, I honor you.
In the name of God, amen.
In the name of God, amen.
Andrew and Elizabeth have now accepted each other in marriage. In the name of God, I declare them to be husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride.
Susan Kennedy and Ron and Rose Kirk welcome you all here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mr. and Mrs. Kirk.
Let me thank you for coming, joining us in this wondrous celebration. I must admit, this is a surprisingly emotional occasion for me, so I hope you'll allow me a few moments to express how I feel, and of course, how Susan feels. Firstly, let me tell you just how much we love our beautiful daughter, how proud we are of her, and proud of our new son, Drew. It's very difficult to tell your children just how much joy they bring to you. Invariably, it sounds like a bad greeting card, I suppose, no matter how heartfelt. But I think that joy is perhaps the most precious gift you can give, even if the giver is unaware of the giving. Perhaps even more so then. For the last 22 years, Elizabeth has showered us with diamonds, sparkling, unforgettable moments of pure happiness. And this from the girl, who declared at the age of 12 that marriage was old-fashioned and she would never participate in the state of holy matrimony. At the age of 16, when she finally conceded the possibility of getting married, she declared it would not be until the age of 35. And then, mercifully, along came Drew to prove that the best-laid plans do indeed gung aft a galay. That's right, Fergus.
Aye, aye.
And thank goodness he did, because in Drew, we have a son-in-law we respect, we trust, and we love. And in choosing him, Libby has shown very good sense, and we're immensely grateful to you, darling. And Susan, who recognised Drew's qualities long before Libby did, is pleased to be vindicated. Well, thank you for your attention, and have a wonderful night.
Ladies and gentlemen, there's always been a tradition at Kirk weddings, and I'm going to ask my son Drew to get up and uphold this tradition with a little help from Harold and Fergus. Drew?
Summertime is coming, and the trees are sweetly blooming, and the wild mountain thyme grows around the purple heather. Will ye go, lassie? Will you go, good neighbors with a little understanding. You can find the perfect land. Neighbors should be there for one another. That's when good neighbors become good.
And go.